What do you think it is about the concept of the Purge that has stood the test of not only the films but now the television show?
Well, I think the Purge has gotten much more relevant in today's America. Sadly, I was saying before, I wish I would be much happier if there was no more Purge and no more Trump, but I think Trump has made the Purge much more relevant and timely, which is good for our show and our movie, but bad for society.
When it comes to the show, what is having those 10 episodes to explore opened up for you versus the films?
The film by nature is very plot driven, and so the films of the Purge have to really focus on action and these big events, and the TV series gives us the real estate to delve into how people's behavior changes when there's a purge once a year, and that's been a really fun creative thing to get to do.
Speaking of fun, one of the coolest things here at Comic-Con is Purge City. What is it like for you to check that out today?
I love Purge City. Purge City is, you know, we were saying I wish we'd done Purge City for the first movie, because Purge City really emphasizes the absurdity and the insane notion of what the Purge is, and so I really loved it. I love shopping there. In fact, I got this shirt here at Purge City.
When it comes to the Purge, what would the video game be?
The video game would be a first-person shooter game of some sort. I don't know what it would be, but if some first-person shooter game. We're actually eventually going to get around to doing a video game for The Purge. I think it'd be pretty cool.